Welcome to this new episode of Icelandic Tunnels, but today I'm showing you Héðinsfjarðargöng and how they connect to other tunnels and towns in northern Iceland. My name is Gylfi and feel free to join me as we find out what it means for the smaller towns to have open roads all year around to places like the capital of northern Iceland, Akureyri, and that is where we start today. Here we have Vaðlaheiðargöng, a private project financed with the road tolls since our MPs were really not likely to put them on budget for the next 200 years or so. But the tunnels did secure open winter road to eastern Iceland, but the old road was in fact closed on a regular basis. Now that was unacceptable because Akureyri has an international airport and the biggest hospital outside of Reykjavík, plus all the other services it provides to the neighboring rural districts. Now, as we move up north, I want to remind you that I have several videos coming online about the towns on the way, but first we are stopping here near Olafsfjordur. Now, those tunnels, they have rescued some lives, I can tell you that. And from those mountains you can see the need for tunnels in this area. And now we are going to talk about the next fjord to the west, and that is Siglufjordur. The problem Siglufjordur had to deal with through time are maybe more than Olafsfjordur did, because of how high mountains are around the town, and there were only two roads leading out to Siglufjordur, both of them only usable for 3-4 months a year. So the rest of the time the people had to use ships. This road here up on this mountain is one of the roads that the people here had to use in the old days. It goes through this mountain pass and they had to blow the top of the mountain away with dynamite in order to get the road through there. The second road from Siglufjordur lies into Olafsfjordur, but it's also a horrible road, only usable a few months a year. So that brings us to these tunnels that are 800 meters long, and the project started in the 50s and ended in 1967, made with very old-fashioned techniques. Those tunnels did open Siglufjörður to west, but it was still many hours to drive to Akureyri. So in 2006, it was decided to open new tunnels between those rather remote fjords. And here we are on the Olafsfjörður side of the tunnels. Please note that the quality would be better since it's rather dark in there, but I'm speeding up in order to avoid boredom from these tunnels. But to the technical data, it's actually two tunnels we are going through now, spanning total 10.6 kilometers. Now, they were highly scrutinized because of their cost, because there aren't that many people that live here. So many people from Reykjavík said, why not move the people to Reykjavík? It's way cheaper than to build those tunnels. But the cost of the tunnels by the time they were ready in 2010 was $106 million. Actually, most, if not all Icelandic tunnels have got their share of criticism before construction, but after construction, we don't hear anything. Now, we are almost through the first tunnels now, but what makes these tunnels so special is the fact that they go through this remote fjord that's called Héðinsfjörður, and the tunnel project got its name from that, Héðinsfjarðargöng. An easy to remember and easy to pronounce Icelandic name. And here we are in this remote fjord, but there were people living here until 50 years ago, but since it's only been visited by hikers. There are only a few people living here occasionally on like caravans, but I think it's on private land, so it's always very quiet and nice here. Towards history, this fjord was the scenario of Iceland's worst aviation accident. Douglas DC-3 flew into the mountain that is on the far left in front of us, but that was in 1947, before the days of modern technology. The plane hit fog and it's believed that the captain was trying to turn it around to Reykjavík, and all 25 people died there as it crashed into the mountain. The plane was on the way to Akureyri. It was only last year that Akureyri got agreement for having ILS equipment set up there, because the international airport there is midst between the mountains. This has meant that some of the planes that have been flying directly from Europe to Akureyri have had to turn around and land in Keflavík due to maybe overcast. and sometimes minor issues that in many cases can be blamed on lack of pilot experience of this area. So ILS is a part of it to make the international airport in the north something to compete with Keflavík, because what we need now in Iceland is not more tourists, but we need to spread the tourism more around the country. Now, the towns, Olafsfjordur and Siglufjordur, they merged into one administration unit called Fjallabyggð by the time the tunnel opened. Tourism has blossomed here, and especially on the Siglufjordur side, but it's to thank to a local businessman that got home from abroad with, well, how can I describe it, bunch of money. And instead of doing what so many other do to stash them in Tortola, he decided to invest in his old hometown, and so he did. And since the tunnel opened, the population in Siglufjordur has increased, but it has declined in Olafsfjordur. But there are multiple reasons behind that, so I'm not going through that. It's safe to say that tunnel does not make towns, but they make towns livable. And that's always the basis in order for them to grow. So overall, it's been considered as a successful merger. And the majority of the residents, they travel a lot between the towns for shopping, services, events, and social participation. I actually like Siglufjordur a bit better because it's more to do there, and if you go on the webcams that I'm linking to in the video, you will see what I'm talking about. But even if Siglufjordur is more like social friendly town, Olafsfjordur is, well, not less of a town. It's more quiet, and that's for some people. So if you want to know more about the towns around here, I urge you to check out my videos, because I already have a video online over Olafsfjordur, and Siglufjordur will be online in just few days. And finally, this was the last tunnel to cover in Northern Iceland, but I've got Eastern Iceland left and Western Iceland as well. And with that, I send you my warmest regards from Iceland.